The light abideth within thy heart again. Full valiantly didst thou overcome thy many trials. But glory not in thy success. For the servants of darkness are ever close at hand. Receive of me my blessing once more. And go forth to shine thy light on all creation.
Thou hast broken down the wall I built around thee, and partaken of thy mistress's blessing once more. Strong art thou, mortal, stronger than any other of thy kind. Having looked upon thy deeds, I am convinced thou art worthy to bear her light. The covenant bound me to thee, but 'twould seem our fates were mingled from the first. Though I will not fight thy battles, I will yet lend thee my wings.
Ugh! crush you underfoot! the champion of Hydaelyn.
Tell me, why do you despise the primals so? They are the embodiment of mortal will, of mortal desire. Plainly, you desire a foe to despise, and 'tis well that you do, for it is from the vortex of ceaseless conflict that Lord Zodiac shall be reborn.
Through the joining, the world shall become whole again. Then all shall be as once it was, as it should ever have remained.
For the glory of Lord Zodiac.
Your meddling ends here and now, Warrior of Light.
Darkness shall consume light. Bested by the likes of them. La Habrea, it is time.
Very well. Let us show these mortals the true power of the Echo. The power to break down the barriers of existence.
Thank you.
that he might regain the blessing of light I had foreseen. But he has grown so strong in it as to deny us our power.
Let us withdraw, Lahabrea. That power remains to us, at least.
So, you harnessed the Eye's power. A pity you spent it all. What will you do now, hero?
So, not even the vaunted Warrior of Light can unmake an Ascian without relying upon mortal contrivances. In the distant past, King Thordon and his Knights 12 fought and defeated Nidhogg. Though the victory cost them dear, they were rewarded with a great prize, the Dread Worm's Eyes, both of which have since been held in the Holy See's safekeeping. The Eye you possess was Nidhogg's left, and long has it served as a source of the Azure Dragoon's might. As for its twin, it has lain here, joined to the person of Haldreth, the first Azure Dragoon. For though he learned to harness its power, he was ultimately consumed by it. Even in death, his body decays not. A pitiful end for a fabled hero. My Ascian friend, long have you and your kind sown the seeds of chaos by teaching mortals the secrets of summoning. But if you assumed that we would meekly serve as your pawns, then you are gravely mistaken. You would raise a hand against us.
By taking unto my flesh the soul of the legendary King Thordon, I can become a god!
knows not cessation, whose being is sustained by a millennium of fervent prayer and the eyes nigh bottomless reservoir of ether.
What?
Your contempt for man has proven your undoing, Ascian. For my first act as God King, I do hereby sentence you to die! Issue with my godhood, I shall answer you with my blade.